Hi everyone, my name is Eric Schroeder and I'm the product manager for the IDE group here at GitLab, and I'm very excited to share with you the latest feature in the remote development category called Workspaces. Workspaces are available in beta on gitlab.com and in self-managed instances, and they provide ephemeral, reproducible, personal remote development environments right within GitLab. I want to give you a quick primer on how to configure them, and then I'll give you a demo of the feature in action. Our initial iteration for Workspaces is sort of a bring your own infrastructure solution. So the first and most important prerequisite is that you bring a Kubernetes cluster to the table. This can be hosted on a cloud platform of your choice or in your own server. But you need to have a Kubernetes cluster that supports the GitLab agent for Kubernetes. That's the first prerequisite. And then once you have that, you install the GitLab agent, the GitLab Workspaces proxy, which handles authentication, and an ingress controller, so you can communicate in and out of the container. Once you have those prerequisites installed, you can enable remote development on your agent config file with just a couple lines of code here in the documentation. So the next step is to prepare a project with a dev file. Now, a dev file describes your development environment in code, and it is an example here in this project has a container image, and that can be hosted on the GitLab container registry or anywhere else that's accessible to you. You can set memory and CPU limits, and you can expose endpoints for your preview servers. Once you have that dev file stored in the root level of your project, you're ready, and you can start creating your first workspace. So I'll go here to my list of workspaces. You can see one is already running, but I'll create a new one here. I'll select the project. And the agent that I have configured. In this case, I only have one, but you can have multiple agents at the group level. And then we have the ability to set a time limit for automatic termination to preserve and use your cloud resources more efficiently. If you wanted it to shut down automatically after an hour or 5 hours or 24 hours, you can configure that here. Now I'll create my workspace, and here it is provisioning that resource in the Kubernetes cluster for me. It's installing the container image and configuring all the dependencies and options that were described in the dev file. Great, now that it's done, I'm gonna click the link. And I've opened up the web IDE here in the workspace. We are editing directly in the workspace. We plan on supporting multiple editing experiences in the future, but right now we are supporting VS Code, our web IDE, in the container itself. And I'll open up the README. You can see this is a pretty standard, you know, text editor. My changes are tracked in the source control, but more importantly, I have access to a fully interactive shell terminal. So in here, I will do npm start. npm install. And then npm start. Now you see the node server is running on port 3000, which is what I defined in the dev file. I'll show you a quick way to open up that preview link here. I'll paste it in here, change the port in the front of the URL. And just to see the node output, I'll show it to you in JSON. So that's the header request for the node server, and you can see it's running in the workspace. Now what I do here, I can commit back to the repository, I can configure additional dependencies, and I can do whatever work I want to complete my development task, and when I'm done, I can shut down my workspace, and the resources are freed, and I'll be able to create a new one for my next task. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the demo, and I can't wait to see what you do with our Workspaces beta. Thank you.